Friends, here I'm having a problem from IIFT 2012 paper. A hemispherical ball is filled with hot water to the brim. The contents of the ball are transferred into a cylindrical vessel whose radius is 50% more than its height. If diameter of the ball is the same as the that of vessel, the volume of the hot water in the cylindrical vessel is. Now problem seems to be complicated. Huge datas are there. But believe me, no paperwork is required at all. See, volume of water, whether it is in hemispherical ball or whether it is in cylindrical vessel, it will remain same, right? Shape of the container may change, but volume cannot change, right? So what will be the volume of the hot water in the cylindrical vessel? That's 100% of the cylindrical vessel, right? No change at all. So if you are transferring the content from ball to vessel, a cylindrical vessel, there is no loss of water. So it will be like 100%. Okay. So there's a big story given over there, but the solution is very simple, right? So sometimes we're stuck up with such problems. We have to read the problem carefully before we attempt it. Okay. In this question, 8 points lie on the circumference of a circle. The difference between the number of triangles and the number of quadrilaterals that can be formed by connecting these points. Now friends, since the points are on circle, that means they all of them are non-collinear. That means no three points are on a single line, right? Now we have to find out the number of triangles. So we need 3 points to make a triangle. So 8 points, we can take the combination of three points to make the triangles, minus 8c4 for quadrilaterals, right? So 8c3, it's 8 into 7 into 6 by 6, minus 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 by 4 into 3 into 2, right? Just solve it. So that's 56 minus 70, so that's 14, okay? I hope you are clear. Now, this problem from IIFT 2012. The perimeter of a right angle triangle measures 234 and hypotenuse measures 97. The other two sides of triangle are measured as 234 minus 97, that means 137. So the sum of other two sides is 137, right? Now option 1 cannot be true because hypotenuse is the largest length in a right angle triangle. So now here we are option as 100 meters, so that cannot be the length of any of the sides. So you can discard that. Apart from that, friends, if suppose this is the correct choice, that means what? 72 square plus 65 square is 97 square. Now here there are two ways. The first way is you just solve it, match left hand side and right hand side. The other way is you calculate unit digit, match the unit digit, and then you match the digital root of both the sides, right? I'll explain you both the methods, but whatever suits you, you can adopt that, right? See, 72 square is what? 2 2s are 4, 7 2s are 14, 2s are 28, 7 7s are 49 into 5 1 8 4 plus 6 into 7 4 2 2 5. And 97 square is 7 7s are 49, 4 carat, 9 into 7 63, into 2 126, plus 4 130, 0, 9 9s are 81, 81 plus 13 is 94. Now match 4 plus 5, 9, 8 plus 2, 10, 1 plus 2, 3 and 1, 4, it matches, that means 100% it is correct choice, right? You'll be fully sure. Or what you can do is you can match the unit digit and then digital root. Here the unit digit is 4, here the unit digit is 5, 4 plus 5, 9, and here the unit digit is 9. So that matches. In that case, you don't have to do this step, right? In that case, you just have to match the unit digit. And if you wish to go for digital root concept, then you just take the digital root of left hand side and right hand side both as well, right? In that case, you don't have to do this. You have to go for any of the method. So digital root of this is 9 plus digital root of this, 6 plus 5, 11. 11 means 2 and 2 square. The digital root is 4. So digital root of left hand side is 4. And if we talk about right hand side, So it's 7 plus say 7 square. 7 square is 49. 49, that means 9 plus 4, 13. That means 4. So digital root of this side is also 4. So digital root and unit digit, both of them are matching. And if we see left-hand side and right-hand side, so this is the correct choice, right? So you have to take one of the method, not both of them. If you just square the terms and get the result like this, then also it's okay, because in that case you are 100% sure, right? And in other case, when we talk about digital root method and unit digit method, since there is none of this, so bit up 1% or maybe a 2% risk is involved. Okay, I hope you are getting my point. So precisely option 2 is the correct choice. Okay, this question once again from IFT 2012. The Howrah-Puri Express can move at 45 km per hour without its rack, and the speed is diminished by a constant that varies as the square root of the numbers of wagons attached. If it is known that with 9 wagons the speed is 30 km per hour, what is the greatest number of wagons with which the train can just move? Now, initially the speed is what? 45, right? After that, if wagons are attached, the speed is reduced. Now that's k root w, right? If speed is diminished by a constant that varies as the square root of the number of wagons. So I assume the number of wagons is w. So speed is being reduced by a constant that varies as the square root of number of wagons, right? So this is the speed if we attach any wagons with this engine, right? Now the relationship is this. Now we are given that if 9 wagons are attached, the speed is 30. So I put the value of S is 30, 45. I would calculate the value of K over here, and W is 9. So root W, that's root 9, that's 3. Okay, so K will be this 45 minus 30 by 3, that's 5, right? Okay, now we have to find out the greatest number of wagons with which the train can just move. That means this 45 minus 5 root W, 45 minus 5 root W should be greater than 0, right? That means there should be some speed at least. Okay, now we can choose the number of wagons from options. Maybe if we are asking about 64, right? If W is 64, in that case root W 64, that means it is 5 into 8, 40. So 45 minus 40, that is pretty big. Suppose I choose 81, so it's 81 that comes out of the square root. It will be 5 into 9. 45 minus 45, that's 0, right? That means when 81 wagons are attached, the speed becomes 0. That means if 80 wagons are attached, that means there will be at least some speed, right? So your answer is not 81, but it's 80. Okay, you should be clear about it. Option 3. Okay, speed is 80. I'm sorry, wagons are 80. Now we have this problem from IFT 2012. Here we have to find out the value of this expression. Now friends, no paperwork is required at all. Now we assume this entire expression to be x, right? And the same sequence is going on till infinity, right? So I just, for clarity, I write over here, right? This sequence till infinity, I'm writing it as x. Okay, because from infinite terms, if I take one, just this outer one, it won't create much difference, right? So what I do is I take this as further x, right? If you just hide this expression over here, it is the same expression, that is x. So x is this thing. Now you don't have to go for any sort of paperwork. You try and put the value of x from options, right? If you see, it should come out of the square root. So you choose the value of x by which this expression should come out of the square root. Okay, so if we choose x is 3, So what we'll be getting? 7 minus 3, that's 4. So square root of 4 will be 2. So 7 plus 2, 9, and square root of 9 is 3. So we started with 3 and we are ending up with 3, right? So x will be what? It's nothing else but 3. So no paperwork is required. I hope you are clear. Okay. Now friends, here I am having a problem from Z 2013. This is the expression that is given to us, and here A, B, C, D, E are positive numbers. We have to find out the minimum value of this expression. Now friends, there is hardly any need to go for paperwork, right? So if you wish to find out the minimum value, just put the value of A, B, C, D, E, all of them as 1 only, right? So it's 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, that's 3 raised to 5 by 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, that's 3 raised to 5 only, that's 243, right? So the answer will be 243. Now, it's not necessary to solve this problem just by putting the value of A, B, C, D, E as 1, right? You can go methodically also. I just wish to share a funda behind this problem. See, arithmetic mean of two numbers is always greater than their geometric mean. This is the theory that you might have studied various times. Arithmetic mean of two numbers, here I'm taking two positive numbers, so arithmetic mean of two positive numbers is greater than their geometric mean, right? So if the two numbers are A and B, so A plus B by 2 will be greater than equal to root AB. Here arithmetic mean of A and B is A plus B by 2 and their geometric mean is root AB, right? Now suppose instead of B, I take the number 1 by A, right? So one number is A, another is 1 by A. So arithmetic mean of A and 1 by A will be this, and it should be greater than their geometric mean. So it's A into 1 by A, that's 1 only, right? So that means what? A plus 1 upon A is greater than or equal to 2, right? Root 1, if we take root 1, that may be positive 1 only, because A and B, both of them are positive, right? So square root of a positive number will be positive only. So A plus 1 upon A is greater than or equal to 2. That means sum of a number and its reciprocal is always greater than or equal to 2, right? Always be very careful. Sum of a number and its reciprocal is always greater than equal to 2 if the number is positive. Here A is positive, so A plus 1 upon A will always be greater than equal to 2. Okay, it will be equal to 2 only in one case, when A is 1. Otherwise it will always be greater than 2. Okay, now how it is used over here, just watch it carefully. I just copied this expression, just one part. A square plus A plus 1. Now if I take A as common, what it will be? A plus 1 plus 1 upon A, right? Now what? A plus 1 upon A. The minimum value of A plus 1 upon A is what? 2. Minimum value. So it's the entire expression, the minimum value will be 2 plus 1. That's 3, right? So this expression, the minimum value is 3A. Similarly, this is 3B, 3C, 3D and 3E. So I just write it over here. 3A into 3B into 3C into 3D into 3E and divided by ABCDE. Right? So ABCDE will be cancelled. So you will be left with 3 raised to 5. That's 243. Isn't it very easy? You can directly put the value, and if you wish to go algebraically or by the regular method, you can go like this. Right? I had proved that both of them are giving the same answer. Okay. Here friends, I am having one more problem from Z 2013. Ramesh bought a total of 6 fruits, apples and oranges from the market. He found that he required 1 orange less to extract the same quantity of juice as extracted from apples. If Ramesh had used the same number of apples and oranges to make the blend, then which of the following correctly represents the percentage of apple juice in the blend, right? We do not know the quantity of the juice which is extracted from the fruits. Now what we can do is we can assume the quantity, right? Suppose I assume that 100 ml juice is prepared, right? So to prepare 100 ml juice, 3 apple is required. Suppose Okay, so to prepare 100 ml juice, only 2 oranges will be required, right? As it is mentioned that 1 orange less to extract the same quantity of juice, right? So to prepare 100 ml, 3 apples are required. To prepare 100 ml, 2 oranges are required, right? Now we have 6 fruits and we have equal number of oranges and equal number of apples. Equal number of oranges and apples, I'm sorry. So suppose 6 fruits, so 3 apples and 3 oranges. Now from 3 apples, we'll be getting 100 ml juice. From 2 oranges, we get 100 ml juice. So from that means from 3 oranges, we'll be getting 150 ml juice, isn't it? Okay, so 100 ml from 3 apples and 150 ml from 3 oranges. So in all, there is 250 ml juice. Out of that, we have to find out the percentage of apple. So 100 of apple, 150 of orange. So our total 250, out of that 100 is of apple. So it's very, very simple. It's 40%, right? That's none of these. So hardly any paperwork is required. Okay. And this is a problem from ZAT 2013. So you can see that the level of the problem is not that difficult. You just have to give a small thought over here. I hope you are clear. Now here, once again, I'm having a problem from ZAT 2013. A number is interesting if on adding the sum of the digits of the number and the product of the digits of the number, the result is equal to the number. What fraction of numbers between 10 and 100 is interesting? Now the problem is also very interesting. We have to find out the number of two-digit numbers that fulfill this condition, right? Any two-digit number can be represented as x, y. Here, x and y are digits, right? If I have to present this digit into numbers, so it will be 10x plus y. How? Suppose I have number 27, so it will be what? 2 into 10 plus 7. That means 2 into 10th digit and plus unit digit. Okay, that means, I'm sorry, not 2 into 10th digit, 10th digit into 10 plus unit digit. So 2 is 10th digit, so 10th digit into 10 plus unit digit. Okay, so this is a number and 2 and 7 are digits. Now, just put up the values in the condition, whatever is given over here, sum of the digits. So that is x plus y, right? And product of the digits. So that is x into y. If we add both of them, we get the number. That is 10x plus y. Now y and y is cancelled. 10x minus x is 9x is equal to x into y. So y is equal to what? 9. So we got the value of y as 9. That means unit digit must be 9. So whenever the unit digit is 9, between 10 and 100, this condition will be fulfilled, right? So it's 1929 till 99. Even you can go for cross verify. That is, sum of the digits is what? 1 plus 9. I take this example. 1 plus 9 is 10. So 10 is added to product of the digits. That's 9. So 10 plus 9 is 19. That is the number itself, right? So we have 1929 till 99. We have 9 numbers, right? So we have 9 numbers and we have to find out the fraction. So what fraction of number between 10 and 100? So both of them are included. So from 10 to 100, we are having 91 numbers. So we have to find out the percentage. We have to find out the fraction only, right? So it will be less than 1, right? 0.1. In fact, I can say less than 0.1. So that's, we don't have any option. So it's none of the above. Okay, that's option 5, right? I hope you are clear. It's a very simple problem, our friends, and you can see that it is from ZAT 2013. So just have to apply a bit of the number sense, nothing else.